So OSHA, the Occupational Safety and Health Administration, which covers workers' health, has set exposure limits. These are permissible exposure limits. So are you are in a workplace, you are permitted to be exposed to up to this concentration of this stuff, in this case over an 8-hour period. So in an 8-hour workday, you should ensure that your ongoing exposure to these toxic pigments and toxic metals stays below that level. So we notice, and the smaller the number is, the less of it you can be exposed to. So arsenic and cadmium, that's a really small number. You're taking 1 milligram per cubic meter and you're cutting that into 0.02 of a milligram per cubic meter. Silver is the second most toxic compound up there by inhalation. And most people have no idea that silver is toxic at all. Well, it's expensive. Gold would be up there too, but nobody's really breathing in gold dust. You know, it's just worth way too much to keep outside of your body to be breathing it in. So we don't worry about overexposure to gold. But silver is pretty darn useful. It gets used in a lot of different industries. Photoprocessing is definitely one of them. And so there is silver exposure, but only by inhalation. And then we go on, lead, cobalt, selenium, and all these other things. And way down at the bottom, we have titanium and zinc and aluminum and iron, and not a big deal. And manganese, from an acute toxic standpoint, is not a big deal. It's not going to poison you. You're not going to die from acute poisoning, like, or get cancer from manganese. But if you get exposed to enough, and it takes quite a bit over a long period of time, then you've got some health problems. So this is all in milligrams per cubic meter, which doesn't mean anything to most human beings. So what's a milligram per cubic meter? Well, a milligram is about how much 1 grain of sand weighs. And a cubic meter is a 3 foot by 3 foot by 3 foot space around your head. So it contains 1,000 quarts of air. So if we go back to our chart, so for a cadmium, let's say you've got a little bit of cadmium, glaze powder. So you take a grain of sand's worth of cadmium grains, glaze powder, you cut it into 200 pieces. You take one of those 200ths of a piece of that glaze powder and you powder that up and you put it in a space this big. And then you cannot be exposed to more than that as you're going through the day on a regular basis. The ceiling level for cadmium exposure is 0.1. The ceiling level is the maximum amount you can be exposed to at any instant in time while you're working, because anything more than that we consider harmful. So now we take the grain of sand, we cut it into 10 pieces, we powder 1/10 of that and put it in the air, and in the whole day you cannot breathe that much cadmium without endangering your health. Which is why if you're working with glazes and you've got cadmium glazes, do not buy them in the paper bags that when you open them up go kapoof, because you're going to exceed the cadmium level. So the scary stuff you want to have wet or in wax or in oil. And that way there's no chance of breathing that stuff in. Iron, you got to breathe a lot of iron dust in order to cause any problems with your health, aside from coughing a lot.